This is Pat O'Malley for Varsity Sports Network, and with me is our player of the year, and he truly was. Jose Torres of Calvert Hall, their standout shortstop who has played on the varsity for the last four seasons, and all four seasons in high school, is likely to be chosen in the Major League Baseball free agent draft, which will start on Monday. Now, Jose, this season, did some big things. He had 8 doubles, 3 triples, and 7 home runs. The 7 home runs lead the team. Batting average was .402. He was second on the team in that to catcher Parker Lamware, who had .452. But I keep a lot of records, and I've been doing this 50 years, and I have never seen the numbers you had in the middle there. 43 hits, 44 RBIs, and 45 runs. Calvert Hall team this year. You've been here 4 years, played here 4 years. You had kind of a down year last year, went 17-11, ranked 15th in our final poll, which was the lowest ever for Calvert Hall. The year before, you were number one, and Loyola stunned everybody by winning it and coming out of nowhere under Coach Kevin Kelly. This year, you guys really got it together. Did the attitude of the team or the demeanor, you know, overall change?
Of course. I mean, after coming out, a year, like sophomore year, we ranked number one. Like you said, Loyola came and upset us. Then going to the next year and coming up, getting knocked out in the playoff first round, that just sparked the hunger in us. Just sparked, this year, that's just not going to happen because that's not what Cowboys is about. So, yeah, the demeanor just changed. Everything just changed. You see the player that was on that team.
Remember any of the seniors that helped you when you first came aboard?
Yeah, I mean, I came in with my brother, so he helped me a lot. I just remember what they taught me, so I try to learn from them and learn from other people and then try to bestow into our other class. So definitely I learned from them. I remember a whole bunch of them.
What about Coach Ackerman? What was he like?
Coach Ackerman, he's more like a military type coach, like old school type of coach, which was very neat. He doesn't baby us, he just tells us everything how it is. So, that's definitely something we need, somebody to humble us, so Coach Edwards is always that type of thing.
Now, from what you know, how do you think the NC State coaches will be?
That would be a really interesting thing to know when I get there, because you know we have Coach Avin. He's like more like a fun guy, but you know he gets down like Coach Echo. And then we got Coach Hart, which he balanced everything out. And then we just had a new pitching coach, just Coach Chrysler. He's more like a fun guy, so it's like a whole mix of everybody. So I'm really excited to get there and start working.
Now looking back on your Calvert Hall days, what are some of your biggest thrills and highlights over the 4 years?
Yeah, I mean, I would cherish every moment. I'll say my biggest thrill is definitely the Grand Slam this year, walk off.
Yeah.
That's just something that doesn't happen.
Gilman.
That's Gilman. That's just something that doesn't happen every day. So I just try to enjoy it. You know, every time I step on this field, you know, for practice, for game, I enjoy it. So I could go down the list and start naming things, but it'll be a lot.
Yeah. When you hit that Grand Slam, did you know as soon as you hit it, it was gone?
Yeah. You just get that feeling like you barely hit the wall, but it's traveling far. You just get that feeling. So I need.
What do you think you need to improve on if you get a pro chance and also now definitely going to get it in college?
I mean, of course. I mean, the biggest thing for me now is gaining weight, gaining proper weight, you know, maybe getting a little bit faster, you know, working my game, keep developing. But definitely just getting more weight, more muscle, so I can hit the ball farther. Seven home runs by 17 or something.
Well, tell the viewers what your height and weight is now and what you'd like to get to.
Yeah, right now I'm 5'12", 6 feet, and I'm 165, so by fall I want to be around 185, so I'm around there just all muscle. So hopefully I get there. I'll be working this summer.
What do you run in the 60s?
6'4".
6'4". That's not bad. You think you could improve that?
I mean, I'm not just talking about velocity, I'm just talking about instinct, like, you know, stealing base, you know, being smarter in the pitch, on smarting people, you know, just working that mental part of baseball, which is very important.
Well, going out a champion and being player of the year by Varsity Sports Network and some other members of the media, what do you look back on and say, hey, this is where I started to develop? Point of time in your career?
Yeah, I'll definitely say when I was like 5 years old, that's when I first started playing baseball. So it just goes back to all over there. You know, I grew up in Miami. I grew up in an academy. Okay. I learned a lot through the years. So it's definitely playing every day, you know, having the good weather, you know, help a lot. So definitely that's where I started. Then I got here to Calvert Hall. Like, I moved back to Baltimore when I was going into my sixth grade year. And when I got to Calvert Hall, then, you know, I just started, you know, the game just started slowing down. I just started getting better, started getting a little stronger, a little quicker. So definitely, you know, starting from 5 years old, I would change everything I did to this point.
Do you have a hero in baseball or an idol?
Yeah, it's a couple people. I'll definitely say my brother. You know, I learned a lot from him, try to follow his footsteps. But, you know, since I was younger, a player that I always watched, you know, I always, you know, try to imitate my game off is Jose Reyes. Yes, he always played with that intensity. He always played with a chip on his shoulder. So it's definitely a player I always, you know, dream of, you know, imitating him when I was young.
Now, going out as a champion, what does your family mean to you at this point?
I mean, it means everything. It's the backbone to, you know, to me. You know, they just love the sport of baseball, so they're always there at practice, at the game. I always see them, even when it's cold early in the year, they're there supporting me. So it's definitely you know, like a hunger to me to see them here, you know, every day, you know, supporting me. You know, it just sparks me, just make me play for them, make me play for another person, not just myself. So, you know, they mean a lot to me.
Well, Jose, congratulations on a great career and a great 2019 season. You were unquestionably the player of the year in the Baltimore metro area.
Thank you, sir.
Good luck in the future.
Thank you.
This is Pat O'Malley for Varsity Sports Network.